when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung up a chimney with care, in the hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled snug in their beds, with visions of sugar plums inside their heads. And Mama, in her kerchief, and I in my cap, had just settled down for a long winter's nap, when, out on the lawn, there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter. Away to the window, I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters, and threw up the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave the luster of midday to objects below. When, what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and eight tiny reindeer? With a little old driver, so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be something more rapid than eagles his course as they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner and Blitzen, to the top of the wall, to the top of the porch, now dash away, dash away, dash away. As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky, so up to the housetop, of course as they flew, with the sleigh from toys and St. Nicholas too. And then, in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each tiny hoof. As I drew in my head and was turning around, down the chimney, St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur, from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. His eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry. His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry. His droll little mouth was drawn up in a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe hat held tight in his teeth, and the smoke it encircled his head like a wreath. He had a broad face and a round belly that shook when he laughed like an old jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf. And I laughed when I saw him, in spite of myself. A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread. He spoke not one word, but went straight to his work and filled all the stockings, then turned to the jerk. And laying his fingers side of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose. He sprang to his sleigh, to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down on a pistol. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all!"